The main purpose of the heart is to pump blood to all the organs of the body so that all the organs receive adequate oxygen and nutrients, so that it is very vital for our survival. Now, heart basically is a pump which consists of four chambers, amongst which the most important chamber is called the left ventricle. Normally, if 100 ml of blood comes into the left ventricle, with each contraction around 55 to 75 ml of blood is pumped outside, so as to say the ejection fraction is around 55 to 75%. This is called the efficiency of the heart. Now, whenever for any reason if the efficiency of the heart comes down, like if the heart fails to pump based on the demand, then we call it as heart failure. Now, heart failure is a very rapidly increasing heart disease with almost of epidemic proportions. Large amount of money and material is spent on managing heart failures world over. We have significant population coming with heart failures, and most common cause for this heart failure is prior heart attack or as a consequence of coronary artery disease. Otherwise, other causes are valvular heart disease, congenital heart disease, primarily diseases involving the muscles of the heart, which we call as cardiomyopathy. Many toxins like, you know, chronic alcohol abuse and other poisons can give rise to chronic heart failure. Nutritional deficiency like thiamine deficiency, selenium deficiency also causes heart failure. When the heart fails to pump adequately according to the demands of the body, progressively the person becomes weak. There is lot of fluid retention. The patient may develop swelling of his feet, breathlessness on walking, breathlessness which increases on lying down, coughing, fatigue. All these things are hallmark features of congestive cardiac failure. Generally, management depends on correcting the underlying cause, like opening of blood vessels and restoring blood flow, repairing and replacement of the valves, congenital heart diseases which have to be corrected, treatment of the underlying nutritional deficiency, so on and so forth. By and large, most congestive cardiac failures can be managed with medical management and other procedures which I just enumerated. However, when the congestive heart failure is very bad, very extreme, when the heart fails to perform its adequate functions even at rest, if the ejection fraction is less than 15, then many times they may require specialized devices called as ICDs and CRTDs, and in extreme conditions they may even require cardiac transplantation.